The beat 'em up. A long-standing staple in arcades across the country, a linchpin in 90s gaming, these experiences cemented four-person multiplayer as a thing long before the Nintendo 64 normalized it in our homes. The rush of beating goon after goon to a pulp. The excitement of stepping into the shoes of your favorite superhero or cartoon character. The exhilaration of hunting down five other friends in order to fill the two-screen X-Men arcade cabinet. I only ever got four. These feelings of nostalgia came rushing back to me as I double-tapped the joystick in Bitmap Books Go Straight, the ultimate guide to side-scrolling beat-em-ups. This is over 450 pages of hardback, full-color, gaming history goodness. It's not just pictures. The author, Dave Cook, dives into every entry, talking about the development, the history, and the cultural impact of every beat-em-up game ever made, from 1984's Kung Fu Master to 2020's Streets of Rage 4. It's absolutely insane the amount of knowledge in this book. Friends and folks, welcome to the Kaiju Lounge. I'm your boss monster, Noah Waterman, and these are the top five things I learned from Go Straight. Kunio-kun is based on a real person. Kunio-kun is best known as the protagonist or antagonist, depending on how you feel about someone who always gets into fights, of the Kunio-kun series, best known as River City Ransom in the US. However, his first appearance was in Taito's Renegade, developed by Technos Japan. Kind of like how Spider-Man's first appearance was Amazing Fantasy number 15 and not, you know, Spider-Man. Crazy enough, the creator, Yoshihisa Kishimoto, based Kunio-kun on himself. Apparently, he spent most of his teenage years getting into fights on a daily basis, spurred on by a bad breakup with his high school sweetheart. Gotta say, the boy had a chip on his shoulder. Glad he finally went into the relaxing and not at all stressful world of game development. Ninja Savior is a remake of a remake. The Ninja Saviors was a 2019 release for the PS4 and Nintendo Switch with some awesome old-school gameplay, but I'm getting ahead of myself. In 1987, Taito released The Ninja Warriors, an arcade beat-em-up set in a dystopian future where you play as Ninja or Kunoichi. Not the most memorable game when we think of arcade classics, but it was notable for a three-screen setup that created the appearance of a triple-wide screen, kind of like the X-Men cabinet, but with one more screen and four less players. It still did well enough to get a follow-up made for the Super Nintendo 7 years later, also titled The Ninja Warriors. Well, that's not confusing. Still published by Taito, but developed by Natsume, specifically the same three-person team that worked on Wild Guns. This was actually a retelling of the original story, this time fitting in a 4x3 square, it added an additional character to choose from. Fast forward another 25 years later, and this version was again remade for modern consoles, with two additional characters and plenty of tweaks. Just goes to show that legends never truly die, not when we can monetize their corpse. Hyulirula exists. That's it, that's the entry. Released by Taito in 1991, funny how they keep showing up on this list. Hyulirula is very Japanese. You play as either Mel or Zack, who are looking to defend Radishland from a bad man that stole the time key to stop the flow of time. No, I didn't just have a stroke. No amount of comments or funny quirks will do this insane game justice, so I'm gonna blast you in the face with a montage, which is the most accurate way to describe this cacophony of color, while I give it a confused stare. I think he just got a contact high. Rival Turf, Brawl Brothers, and Peacekeepers are a trilogy. Now, if you said who, what, and huh to that, you're not alone. All three were the type of game you'd see on a Blockbuster shelf but never actually rent. However, these three random Final Fight SNES knockoffs were actually part of an epic story known as the Rushing Beat Trilogy. Now, with localization, this is going to get a tad confusing. Rival Turf was initially released in Japan as Rushing Beat and developed by Jaleco. Thought I'd say Taito, didn't you? Rushing Beat is the story of Rick Norton and his friend Douglas Bill trying to save his girlfriend and the city of Neo Cisco, that's San Francisco in the future, obviously, from a crime ring selling illegal substances. Rival Turf is a story of Jack Flack and his friend Uzi Nelson trying to save his girlfriend in the city of Los Angeles from the street kings. Okay, fine, that's relatively standard. Later that year, Jalico released Rushing Beat Ran, which again starred Rick Norton and Douglas Build, along with three new characters, Lord J, Kazan, and Wendy Milan. In America, all connections to the previous game are lost. The game is called Brawl Brothers, and Rick and Douglas are renamed to Hack and Slash. Both Rick, Hack, or Jack Flack, and Douglas, Slash, or Uzi now own a dojo, and the mad scientist Iceman, or Dieter, unleashes an army of clones on a nondescript American city. About a year after that, Rushing Beat Shura is released. The game takes place in the far future of 2015, after the economic wars of 2011. We've had a recession, that kind of stands. The Deutschland Moldova Corporation rules the world, and four people affected by their twisted research seek revenge against the corporation. In America, this was known as the Peacekeepers, and the story is mostly unchanged. Get this though, Rick Norton slash Jack Flack slash Hack is unlockable in the game as Rick Norton for the first time in the US. More so, Douglas and Lord J make cameos, although all connections to the previous two games are scrubbed. Three seemingly unrelated beat-em-up games tell an epics trilogy, and it's still not great. Kung Fu stars Jackie Chan. Kung Fu is really the first beat-em-up and created the entire genre. Hell, it's the first entry in this book. So color me shocked when I learned that this game is actually based on a Jackie Chan movie. Hear me out. In 1984, Jackie Chan stars in Wheels on Meals alongside his two close friends and kung fu legends, Sammo Hung and Yuen Biao. Side note, if you don't know Yuen Biao, you gotta check him out. He is amazing. Knockabout might be one of my favorite movies of all time. The three had been students in the Peking Opera School and had already worked together on films like Project A and Lucky Stars. Jackie Chan stars as Thomas, who meets the female star Sylvia and later has to save her from a criminal gang. I'm simplifying it, but that's fine. You should watch it, it's great. The last part of the film shows the three stars infiltrating a castle to save Sylvia. This is very similar to the plot of the game Kung Fu, where the hero, Thomas, has to save his girlfriend, Sylvia, by battling through a castle. Now, both the movie and the game released as Spartan X in Japan. Irem basically combined this idea with Bruce Lee's Game of Death and distributed it in Japan with the Spartan X license. Now, when Data East took it to the West, they left the Spartan X license behind, but make no mistake, this is a continuation of the classic Kung Fu film. Now, released it with Sammo and Yuen as playable characters, the cowards. I'd say that's it, but honestly, there is so much more in this book. Now, I'm not sponsored yet, and I'm not getting anything for this video. Again, yet. So believe me when I say that if you love gaming history, you will love this book. So much knowledge in this literal tome of games heavy enough to kill a small rodent. And this is one of the amazing books on the Bitmap Books site. I will drop a Zelda in the description below. Check them out. It's an absolute must in any gamer's library. What's your favorite beat-em-up game? And why is the battle circuit? Let me know in the comments below after you like this video. And if you want to see more of this kind of video on the channel, then subscribe. That's an awfully great way to convince me. Until next time, stay cool, stay hip, stay heavy.